Hello makers, it's Will from Mekanika. Today I want to talk about the 10 common mistakes that new screen printers make and how to avoid them. We'll be using fabric as our base, and all our tools come from the Mekanika screen printing bundle. So if you're new to screen printing or thinking of starting your screen printing journey, this video is for you. Please like and subscribe. We would love you to become part of our community of makers. And now, without further ado, mistake number one, using low quality stencil. When we say low quality, we mean an ensemble of factors that just don't make your stencil ideal and is prone to more problems. For your first design, start simple. I would suggest that you go for a monochrome design and one without complex shapes. If you're creating your stencil using transparent film and a budget printer, you can print the design twice and layer them to increase the opacity of the design. Mistake number two, not cleaning the screen before coating and printing. The screens we use, whether new ones or old ones that we've stored, collect dust, grease, and debris from old printings. So it's important to wash the screen with a soft sponge and soap. Dish soap is sufficient. After this, you can add screen filler or emulsion to your screen. Mistake number three, not getting the right amount of emulsion to coat your screen. Emulsion is a key element in making a print, so it's crucial that you use it correctly. I know it feels weird to put so much emulsion on the coater, but often people don't put enough emulsion before applying it to their screen. So put more than you need. The good thing is that whatever you haven't used, you can put back in the bottle and use at a later time. Mistake number four, using dirty or wrinkled materials. Using dirty or wrinkled materials will not give you the outcome that you want, and you really shouldn't be printing on dirty clothes. If you want to make a quality print, you need to make sure the surface on which you want to print is clean and regular. For example, if the fabric is wrinkled, it'll cause the ink to spread unevenly. You can also use an adhesive spray to make sure that your base material won't move when placed on the press. We offer this repositionable spray adhesive on our online shop. Mistake number five, not checking or correctly preparing your ink. It's crucial to check and prepare your ink correctly. In screen printing, there are two main ink families, solvent-based and water-based. Here at Mekanika, we use water-based ink. If you're using water-based inks, take the time to mix it thoroughly for a few minutes so the texture becomes almost creamy. Always test the colors on a sample piece of fabric or paper before you start printing. This way, you can be sure of the colors you're using and make sure that the image you want comes out the way you want. Mistake number six, not applying the right amount of pressure when printing your design. One of the most daunting parts of a print is when you need to grab your squeegee and rake it across the screen. How much pressure do you put? Well, it's not an exact science, but here's what we say. Different inks may require different angles, and the same with the squeegee. To add to that, everybody has a method that is comfortable for them. Just try not to have your squeegee be too steep or too low. About a 40 to 60 degree angle should be good. Apply steady pressure when pulling the squeegee across the screen, and don't get discouraged if your first print is not ideal. Practice makes perfect. Mistake number seven, exposing the stencil in reverse. In order to print your design in the right direction, you need to expose it upside down. It'll make more sense if I show you. As you can see here, if I want the dot to be on the left on my tote bag, when I expose my stencil on my screen, I have to make sure that the dot is on the right side. This is because when I flip the screen over for the actual print, it's then going to be right side up. Mistake number eight, forgetting to pre-cure the ink after printing. Just putting ink is not enough. You need to help the ink stain and latch onto the base fabric. Applying heat on the new print is called curing. You should spend a minimum of 30 seconds cooking your design with a hairdryer or a heat gun. Doing this will make sure that the ink won't run or smear. This will also prevent the ink from fading over time especially during washes. Mistake number 9, not cleaning the screen after printing. You need to clean your screen to preserve it. When finished with the design, clean the screen with a dedicated cleaning solution, a soft sponge, or a pressure water hose. This will keep the screen from becoming clogged with ink or emulsion. Depending on how long the ink stayed on the screen, it might be more difficult to clean the mesh. Here, we're cleaning quite an old screen. It took a while, but we got all the paint out. Here's a pro note. Traces of your design may stay on your screen, but don't worry, this won't affect your future prints. This is just the ink having stained your mesh. Mistake number 10, not maintaining and reclaiming your screens. Screens can be used for a long time. You just need to check them regularly to make sure they're free of any tears or any damage. If you're storing screens, make sure that they're in a cool and dry place. This will prevent the mesh from becoming brittle and cracked. And when you no longer need to print an image that is already on a screen, you can reclaim the screen and reuse it several times. There we are, 10 mistakes that we often see with new makers, but they're avoidable with a little bit of practice and attention to detail. If there are any mistakes that you think should be added to the list, let us know in the comments below. Before long, you'll be creating beautiful and professional looking designs. If you're thinking of trying screen printing, check out our Mekanika screen printing bundle. The link is in the description below. We also have a tutorial series guiding you step by step to successfully completing your first print. If you found this useful, leave a like. If you want more content, subscribe. And until the next video, make differently.